This is Girl Remade, an Ella Dark FBI suspense thriller, Book 17. Written by Blake Pierce. Narrated by Amanda Goettl. Prologue. Rebecca Holden sat poised in her leather chair, a fortress of professionalism amid the chaos that sometimes walked through the door. Her office was a carefully curated space of tranquility, walls adorned with diplomas and licenses, plush blue armchairs inviting open conversation, and a large window that bathed the room in natural light. But today, the serenity was strained. Across from her, in one of her welcoming chairs, the young man's presence made for an alarming contrast to the calm decor. His eyes were darting, his fingers tapping an erratic rhythm on the armrest. He was a discordant note in the symphony of her usually harmonious office. "Daniel, is it?" Rebecca asked, her voice a lighthouse beam cutting through fog. "Yes," the boy said. "Daniel is fine." His gaze flitted to the potted fern in the corner before snapping back to some invisible point just above Rebecca's head. The word "fine" seemed to suggest that this young gentleman wasn't about to reveal everything in one fell swoop. "Well, thank you for coming. Would you be able to tell me about yourself?" she probed gently, folding her hands in her lap. Rebecca's intuition, honed from years of practice, sensed the tempest beneath Daniel's calm surface. "Sure," he said, but then fell silent, his foot now joining the restless symphony of his hands. A bead of sweat trailed down his temple despite the room's cool temperature, maintained by a quietly humming air conditioner. Rebecca decided to prod him along. "Sometimes, talking about even the small things can help us understand the bigger picture," Rebecca said. She kept her tone warm and inviting, yet her mind alert to Daniel's clear undercurrents of distress. He shifted in his seat, the leather creaking under his movements.
Sometimes people just annoy you, you know? Like they keep pushing buttons they shouldn't."
Now she was getting somewhere, Rebecca thought. She preferred it when clients got right down to the nitty-gritty.
"Absolutely," Rebecca nodded, watching him closely. "It's normal to feel frustrated when we're provoked."
Daniel's hands ceased their fidgeting for a moment, clenching into fists before resuming their dance. The young man looked as though he wanted to unburden himself of a great weight. Yet something held him back, the words catching in his throat like leaves in a storm drain.
Have you ever wanted to stop someone from causing pain?" Daniel asked.
His voice cracked, barely audible over the quiet ticking of the wall clock.
"Stopping pain is what I'm here for," Rebecca responded, her tone steady, but her heart rate picked up,
sensing the precipice upon which they both teetered.
"Who annoys you, exactly? Someone in particular, or a type of person?"
The room fell silent, save for the young man's labored breathing and the distant sound of traffic from the street below, punctuating the moment like a drumbeat.
"Dr. Holden?"
the young man began, his voice a hoarse whisper that seemed to claw its way out of a deep, dark place within him.
"I have these urges."
The word hung in the air. Rebecca felt a jolt of alarm, her professional composure momentarily sliding like loose gravel underfoot. She leaned forward slightly, hands folded on her notepad, her knuckles the same white as the paper.
"Urges?" she repeated carefully, her mind racing to maintain the facade of clinical detachment. "What kind of urges?"
"Sometimes," Daniel continued, his gaze now fixed on the floor as if he could no longer bear the weight of eye contact. "I want to kill." The confession detonated silently in the room. Rebecca's breath caught in her throat,
her pulse quickening as she processed his words. She had heard many confessions in this room, some disturbing, others heartbreaking, but this was different.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.